Giannis had 24 points, 14 boards, and Brooke Lopez had a monster game with 29 and 11. Milwaukee has been cruising this postseason. Broussard, are the Bucks the actual legit threat to take down the Warriors here?
They are a legit threat. There's no question about it. Now, I will pick Golden State. If they have Kevin Durant, I'm definitely picking Golden State and feel very good about it.
I agree.
If they don't have KD, I still pick them, but I'm very hesitant about that pick. Look, Milwaukee, for this day and age, this style of play that we have today in the NBA, they're almost perfectly built for it. Because you have a guy that's 7 feet tall, can handle the ball, and get into the lane whenever he wants. Even though he's not a great jump shooter, he's actually developing a decent three-point shot. But the fact that he can get in the paint at will.
Break down the integrity of the defense.
Yes. And so now, if you wall him off to stop him, they got all these shooters around. I know Malcolm Brogdon this summer, some of the people he worked out with, he was told by the Bucks when Budenholzer and his staff came in, don't even work on your post game or anything like that. Get on the three-point line, because that's what we're going to do. And that's all they do is set those four guys out on the three-point line, and if Giannis dribble drives or he's in the post, you got to either stop him or he's kicking it out. And their length, too.
Their length
is really – especially if KD's not there, I don't know how Golden State deals with their length.
Kawhi struggled with their length, especially late in the fourth quarter when he got a little tired. Siakam struggled with their length late in the game. So it's a great point as far as defensively. You know, you got to give them some credit. They present a number of problems.
Yes. The one big concern for Milwaukee, who, by the way, with or without Kevin Durant, I'm picking the Milwaukee Bucks to win the NBA championship.
Even with Durant.
This is something that I've been saying since really the playoffs
began. It's been building.
This was pre-Durant injury I was on this, but even so, with or without him. But here's the big concern if and when we get this matchup, and I think it's more win than if. No team in the NBA allowed their opponent to make more threes than the Milwaukee Bucks. They gave up the most threes of any team in basketball. That sounds impossible considering they had the number one defense in basketball. The way you can get away with that is they have multiple great rim defenders. Giannis is a great rim defender. Brooke Lopez has turned into an outstanding rim defender.
Yep.
That length is really hard once you get in, and they don't foul. So if you're not letting guys get free throws, not letting guys get layups, you can give up threes. You would say, can you, though, if you're playing Steph and Klay and Kevin Durant?
They don't shoot as many threes as people think. Now, would they adjust
would
that?
Would they, though, if you're Milwaukee, a team that's daring you to? But other than that, Milwaukee is a team that there are no answers to the questions they present you, which is, how are you going to stop Giannis? Oh, we're going to do what Boston tried to do, what Toronto was trying to do, collapse on him in the lane. He averages 6 assists a game. And those 6 assists, much like we've seen from LeBron in his career, a disproportionate number of those assists are going to three-point shooters. They're worth an assist and a half, essentially, because they're creating 3 points. Defensively, the length is one thing that can bother Steph and Klay. That where you can seem like you are a half step out of position, but because of the length, you are not. They are comfortable playing at any pace. They actually play at a quick pace, 5th in the league, but they can slow it down when you want them to. Charles Barkley keeps saying they have a bad half-court offense. No, they don't. They don't have a sophisticated half-court offense. Mm-hmm. It's not a complex half-court offense, but it's an incredibly effective half-court offense. And what they also have going for them right now is they are the healthiest team left. And when you add 60 wins, but 45 of them were by double digits, you were able to rest guys. Mm-hmm. And that doesn't mean sitting out games, but it means not playing taxing minutes. The only rotation guy that they don't have is Powell. And I don't really know how important Powell is to them.
Especially going against the Warriors.
100%. Right. Yeah. Getting Brogdon back was critical. Having Mirotic come back was important. So I think the Bucks are the best team in the league. I think they are the only team right now that would not only could beat the Warriors, but would beat the Warriors.
A couple things really quick. I believe that their bench would give the Warriors problems. I believe that their four-guard rotation would give the Warriors problems. Because, look, man, they got Middleton, Bledsoe, and they got George Hill and Brogdon coming off the bench. Yeah. So they can throw some stuff. Like, they're not like CJ, where they have to run around, chase Klay around, and he's going to be exhausted. It's going to affect his offense. They can get a rotation of players, and I just believe, watch how the minutes with Brogdon are building. Three seasons ago, he was the rookie of the year. He had a huge impact on the game last night. He is a big dual guard where he can play the point and he can also play off the ball. And he's a knockdown shooter as far as three. And he can guard either Steph and Klay. So there are some things that you see in this matchup. To me, how would they attack the Hampton Five? Lopez. Would they play him on the court, or would they bring somebody else in and have Giannis play the five? I believe Giannis playing the five matches up better against the Warriors as far as them trying to win that series.
Here's the thing with Milwaukee. I mean, if they do what you think, Nick, we've never seen this in the NBA. We've never seen a team go from the 16th best record with no real offseason changes roster-wise and win it. We're used to teams building, the Pistons going through their heartaches and losing to Chicago or you know, to Boston and getting over the hump. Jordan doing the same thing. Even LeBron just individually had his own heartache. We've never seen this. And that's part of why I would pick the Warriors, just the experience. And this is totally unprecedented.
The team we've seen go from mediocre to champion was the big three Celtics, but it wasn't the same team.
No, exactly.
They added Ray Allen. Yes, they added Kevin Garnett. It was totally different. Their big addition this offseason was Mike Budenholzer. That was their big change, was they went from what I believe to be really bad coaching that was not taking advantage of their length, that was not taking advantage of their shooting, to one of the better coaches in basketball.
They played entirely differently last year.
So that was my question about the experience and if it's to a detriment to the Bucks and if the Warriors can take advantage of it. The one thing they don't have, the one thing of everything you guys mentioned, is they don't have that experience.
But also the young Warriors, before they won their first championship, they didn't have any experience either. We're just seeing them now on the back end of it. Giannis, and typically we see the coach and the organization go through some growing pains, but this is an odd year. Man, Golden State, who are they going to be in the finals? Are they going to be down one starter or down two starters? But Milwaukee Bucks, they won 62 games. You can't be a bad organization and win 62 games. They got through those first couple series. Let's not forget, right now, what's their playoff record?
9-1.
Oh, okay, the best in the NBA. So we shouldn't be surprised at what they've done.
Well, you brought up Golden State. That may even be the closest comp. Because the year, you know, they were a good team, but nobody expected them to be able to win a championship. Mm-hmm. And they just come out and they're better than anybody foresaw. So that's actually a good comparison.
And their big addition was a guy who was already on their roster. It was Draymond. It was Draymond going from not being a huge part of what they were doing, removing David Lee.
David Lee was hurt. Kerr lucked into that. He was going to start David Lee.
And then had the courage of his convictions to stick with it, even though David Lee at the time was the highest paid guy on the team. One more small note about Milwaukee, I guess, too. Brogdon, one of the reasons the Warriors have been so hard to beat is you can't win the free throw game against them. If you're down four with 20 seconds left, you've lost because Steph is not going to miss free throws. Brogdon's one of the 10 greatest free throw shooters in NBA history. So Milwaukee has that going for them. And in these 5 years, we've seen the Warriors not have home court advantage in one series. That was against Houston last year. They took them 7. They would not have home court advantage in the finals this year against Milwaukee. I think that's important as well.
All right, Chris, thanks for hanging with us today.
Good job, man.
Take a break. Coming up, is Lev Bell already at odds with his new head coach? Next up, first things, took down the Raptors 108-100 in game one of the Eastern Conference Finals. Giannis had 24 points, 14 boards. And Brooke Lopez had a monster game with 29-11. Milwaukee has been cruising this postseason. Broussard, are the Bucks the actual legit threat to take down the Warriors here?
They are a legit threat. There's no question about it. Now, I will pick Golden State. If they have Kevin Durant, I'm definitely picking Golden State and feel very good about it.
I agree.
If they don't have KD, I still pick them, but I'm very hesitant about that pick. Look, Milwaukee, for this day and age, this style of play that we have today in the NBA, they're almost perfectly built for it. Because you have a guy that's 7 feet tall, can handle the ball, and get into the lane whenever he wants. Even though he's not a great jump shooter, he's actually developing a decent three-point shot. But the fact that he can get in the paint at will.
Break down the integrity of the defense.
Yes. And so now, if you wall him off to stop him, they got all these shooters around. I know Malcolm Brogdon this summer, some of the people he worked out with, he was told by the Bucks when Budenholzer and his staff came in, don't even work on your post game or anything like that. get on the three-point line, because that's what we're going to do. And that's all they do is set those four guys out on the three-point line. And